It's Burkhan here from Next Startups. I am CTO for a tech startup, and I love to talk and learn anything about startups. So today we are going to be talking about Amazon Web Services. Amazon is the most popular cloud hosting service, and its market size is greater than all the other players combined. There are many startups who are new to Amazon, AWS, and they don't have an idea of how much it's going to cost to host on Amazon. This video is a part of a series that will be covering the different services offered by Amazon and their cost calculation. This video is the first of 5 videos I will be doing on Amazon AWS cost calculation. This will be a basic review, and we will not be going into a lot of details because these services are very, very advanced. So this video will start with a cost calculation for Amazon EC2 service. First, we need to go to the calculator provided by Amazon to calculate the cost for using its service. And then we need to select the Amazon EC2 service. Amazon EC2 is also another name for virtual dedicated servers. These servers are basically, because whenever you are hosting, you would need virtual dedicated servers. But these are much more powerful than normal virtual dedicated servers, and I will show you how. So first, you need to select a region. Amazon has different regions where it hosts, where it keeps these servers. So first, you need to select a region where you're hosting it. Then you need to select the compute Amazon EC2 instance, which is basically simply how many cores and RAMs the instance needs to be. So let's put in the description. You need to select the number of instances that you need. Then you need to select how much you're going to utilize this server. So if you need to utilize this, let's say just 50%, then you can select you're just going to utilize it 50% of the month. So let's put in 100% for now. Then you need to select the type of instance. So let's go into this. You can see first you need to select the operating system type. Then you need to select the type of instance. Amazon has a lot of instances. And when I was saying about virtual dedicated servers, you can select a server which is 16 cores and 60.5 gigabits of RAM. So that is a lot. But for this video, we are not going to select that. So let's select a medium option with 2 CPUs and 4 gigabits of RAM. There is an hourly cost for this. So Amazon has this hourly cost calculation model where if you're using a server only for 1 hour or 2 hours or a day, it's only going to cost you for that particular time. But if you're reserving it for an entire year, it will give you a discount of maybe something like 56%. So let's select this. And so see, the monthly cost is 38.07. It's also reflected here of the monthly bill. We can also select if we want to pay 1 year upfront fees, for which if we select, the discount will become applicable. So you can see the one year cost and 3 year cost here. So let's keep the default option for now. When you're selecting a server, you also need to attach an EBS volume, which is basically just kind of storage that you need to attach with this. So let's select a storage type here. Test storage. You can select the number of volumes that you need, and then there are these 3 volume types, which is magnetic, provisioned, IOPS, and general purpose. The magnetic one is the slowest one, general purpose is the second fastest one, and provisioned IOPS is the fastest option, or you can actually select how many IOPS you want. If you want to look at the description of these, you can go to this page where it specifies that general purpose SSD is usually good for these use cases. Provision IOPS is good for critical business applications, sometimes some things that require 10,000 IOPS, and large database workloads such as MongoDB, Microsoft SQL Server, MySQL, and Postgre. And magnetic is something like low storage cost and important, but the ability to access the data fast is not that important. So let's put in a general purpose SSD drive of 100 GB here. And you can see that it gives you 300 IOPS. But let's suppose if you select provision IOPS, it's going to default to 0. So maybe you can select 10,000 IOPS, which is really, really fast. But let's keep the default option, general purpose SSD here. This is the amount of storage that you expect to create a snapshot. So let's suppose we put a 100 GB snapshot storage so that it can take a snapshot of our hard disk. You can select that, and this is going to reflect in the cost. The next thing that we're going to do is that we're going to select the number of elastic IPs. Whenever you want to access your server from the outside world, you're going to need an IP. So Amazon's name for IPs is basically elastic IP. It's called elastic IP because you can attach or detach it from your server anytime, or you can attach it to one server and then move it to another server anytime you want. The next thing that we're going to talk about is the data transfer. So with Amazon, you're also going to pay the cost for data transfers. So if you're hosting on, if you're hosting a video site and using a lot of bandwidth, it's going to cost you a lot, because if you're processing terabytes of data per month, Amazon is going to ask you to pay for that. If you're a low bandwidth site, then you will be billed accordingly. So let's assuming that you're not doing any inter-region data transfer, which is the regions here, you're just keeping it between one region. The data transfer out, let's say you are going to be transferring 200 GB per month, and the cost is going to be reflected here. Let's say the data transfer in is maybe 2000 GB. That is zero cost, so it won't reflect anything on the cost. Public IP, elastic IP data transfer. So it will also charge you on how much data is coming to this IP. So let's suppose it's 200 GB per month, and the cost is going to change here. Then the number of elastic load balancer. So Amazon has this concept of elastic load balancers, which can sit in front of your servers and can distribute the traffic between different servers. And we have also done another video, which you can find in the link below in the video, about how you can use Amazon's elastic load balancer to distribute the traffic between different servers so they can handle the load automatically when you need to scale up the servers. So let's suppose we keep one elastic load balancer and we keep it 200 GB per month, and this is going to increase the cost by a nominal number. The reason we put everything behind a load balancer, even if we are just going for one dedicated server, is that if we need to scale in future, we can add another server anytime we want. And because we have a snapshot, we can use that snapshot to create as many virtual servers as we want. This is it for Amazon EC2 service. In the next video, we are going to be talking about Amazon S3 service. Thank you very much for being with us. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel. Bye-bye.